Well, honestly, Andy, I'm not sure. You said it had to do with how fast the waves are shaking, but the only difference I see here is how spread out the waves are.
That's a really great point, Lauren. This is what's hard about drawing waves. Waves are moving all the time, and when we draw them, we have to draw them still. What you're pointing out when you say the wave is stretched out, maybe from here to here, is called the wavelength of the wave.
But for now, I think Susan actually brought her slinky with her today. So maybe we can go to Susan. Susan, are you there with your slinky by any chance?
Way ahead of you, Andy. Once you started talking about waves, I got a contestant here to help out.
That's great, Susan.
And Susan, do you think you could actually shake your hand up and down really slowly and make a nice low frequency wave for us?
Sure thing, Andy. Here is a large stretched out wave.
It is. Now, what happens if you shake your hand a little faster?
Here, it gets much more compact.
So high frequency waves are squished together and low frequency waves are spread apart?
That's right, exactly. So high frequency waves have a short wavelength, whereas low frequency has a long wavelength. Thanks a lot, Susan. It looks like we're actually getting ready for the next event.
Yep, we'll be ready soon.